Ours is a vast universe, a wondrous creation of subtle beauty and awesome power. And in my travels through the galaxies, I've come to understand that power is a delicate force. In the right hands, it can be extraordinary, benevolent. In the wrong hands, it can be dark and destructive. So when the time came for me to pass along my powers, I came upon four young children who inspired me with their innocence, their honesty. Children to whom I felt I could entrust my powers with the confidence that as they grew, so would their ability to use those powers wisely. I just hope I didn't make a mistake.
Come on, Alex!
What'd you do? Fall in?
You know, Jack, you can be a real pain sometimes.
Oh, I found your science book. It's near my aquarium.
Let's move it, gang. And I better not find clothes all over the place, or there'll be no TV for a week, understand? Julie?
Mom, have you seen my...
What's wrong, sweetheart?
I miss my state golf.
So do we, Katie Cat. But you know what? Maybe we can all go back to the beach and visit them again next summer. Wouldn't that be fun?
Mom, do we have to live here?
You know something, Katie? I think we're going to make lots of new friends here.
Promise?
Promise.
Dad, said if I lost any more retainers, you'd ground me for the rest of my life.
I know what I said, Jack. All right, everybody, listen up. Now, we have discussed this before. What's happened to you kids? These powers you've been given are, well, extraordinary. But it's important to remember that with power comes responsibility to yourselves and to this family. Now, we're new around here, and it's difficult enough to adjust to a new neighborhood. And I just don't think that we should be doing anything to confuse people or draw attention to ourselves. Am I making myself clear?
Yep.
Well, okay then. Team break.
Lunches are on the counter, and I don't want anyone making plans for tomorrow until the house is unpacked. I don't want to hear about it. You've had all week now. It's time to get organized.
Thanks, Dad.
Bye, honey.
Bye.
Bye,
Dad.
Bye.
Bye.
You okay?
Work with me.
Like a girl.
What did you get? Hang around with you. I'm learning something. Bye, Mommy. Come on, Katie.
Is she going to be all right?
Oh, sure. It'll just take some time. What prompted the speech?
Oh, Jack. Caught him getting small again. It's not funny, Maggie. I nearly rinsed him down the drain.
Oh, I know. It still sounds strange to me. You're right, though. I mean, it's hard enough being a kid. You feel awkward, self-conscious, and to suddenly have powers like these, Well, I just worry they're going to feel like freaks.
Or be treated like them. They flash that stuff around. It's going to scare people. The other kids, they'll back right away. Oops. I better call you from the lab.
Okay.
I'm late.
Okay. Maybe here. Bye.
Today, we will be discussing Newton's law of universal gravitation. Now, we've all heard the legend of Sir Isaac Newton sitting under an apple tree, an apple falling on his head, etc., etc. So, what was it that he discovered? What's universal gravitation? Alex.
According to Newton's law of universal gravitation, the force between any two bodies is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the distance between them.
Good. Very good. Now, can anyone state Newton's law of motion? Chill out, Alex. Anyone? Come on, people. This was last night's reading assignment. Jason.
On Fridays, it's the mall. But then on Saturdays, we all hang out at the bowling alley. But, like, we don't bowl or anything. I mean, bowling? Please. But then there's, like, this really great video arcade there. And that's where all the really cute boys go. You know, to show off and stuff. So, like, it'd be really great if you could come. Because that way you'd get to know everyone. So, like, you're gonna come tomorrow, aren't you?
I'm supposed to help my family unpack.
Oh, bummer. I'll be there. Great. You're really gonna like everyone. What did you say your older brother's name is? Alex?
Was this Dr. Mobius anyway?
Some old circus guy turned his house into a museum or a macabre.
What's that?
Like, really weird, freaky stuff. So we're gonna do this, right? After school today? I don't know, guys.
You gonna wimp out on us, Harlan?
Come on, Eddie. No one's been in there since he died. And besides, it's all boarded up.
But Power says he can get us in there. Isn't that right, Jack?
No problem.
See? So we'll all meet there at 4. Right? Okay. Yeah!
So that's why you're so smart. You read whatever you wait around, so you must wait around a lot.
Thanks. I like it in here. It's quiet.
I'm Tina Calloway.
Oh, hi, Alex Power.
I know. Well, it's nice to know you, Alex. Would it be okay to call you sometime You know, like if I ever have any science questions?
Yeah, sure. Let me give you our phone number.
Thanks. I'll call you sometime.
Of blood. I bet you even Dr. Mobius is probably still in there, rotting away inside of one of those old steel cages.
This place really creeps me out.
You creep me out, Harlan. Let's go.
Button it, all right?
Okay, Power Trip, let's see you do your thing.
You guys wait here. I'll be right back.
There's nothing scary in here.
His eyes again. See that? It kind of looks like his eyes are moving, like he's looking right at us.
Yeah.
Hey, did you guys just feel that?
Yeah. It got like real cold in here all of a sudden.
I hate when that happens.
Wow!
What was that? Cool. Where'd it come from?
I don't know. Here.
No, maybe you should keep it. You know, like a souvenir. I mean, you were the one who got us in here.
Mom says she's coming home with a bunch of groceries. She wants you to get started on the kitchen.
Oh, no.
Alex, you've got to cover for me.
I can't. I have to help Jack. He's not even close to finished upstairs.
Please, oh, please. I just want to meet everybody. Then I'll come right home. I promise. Please, Alex. I just, you know, want to make some new friends.
Okay. But I'm serious, Julie. You better be really quick about it, because Mom will be really upset.
I know. I promise. Alex, you're the greatest.
Well, Alex did say to be quick about it.
I think you better come upstairs and take a look at something.
I don't believe this. Didn't you hear anything Dad said yesterday? What if your friends had seen you?
Can we skip the lecture this time, Alex?
Jack, we weren't given our powers so that we could show off.
I know, I'm sorry.
You never should have taken it in the first place, Jack. You shouldn't have been in there.
Come on, work with me on this one, Alex. What are we gonna do?
We've got to put it back where it belongs.
I was afraid you were going to say that.
The poor guy hasn't been himself for days. Absolutely no concentration in the lab. So finally I said to him, Bert, lighten up.
First law in physics is what goes up must come down. Oh, the guys in the lab thought it was pretty funny.
Jim, look at this weather. You think the kids are okay?
Oh, they're fine, Maggie. Probably all unpacked watching TV by now.
Hello?
This way.
Nothing to it.
Sugar? Salt.
Oh, yeah. That's what comes over there. There you are.
Hi, Mom. I'm really sorry.
What are you sorry about?
We weren't here to help with the groceries.
Well, that's okay. We managed.
You guys did a super job unpacking.
Thanks.
Hi.
Hi. Could your daughter come out and play?
Well, Katie Cat, would you like to go out and play with the little girl?
What's your name?
Hello. Well, just a minute. Tina?
Ooh, Tina.
Hi.
Yeah?
Can you hold on for a second, Tina? Do you guys mind?
No.
Of course not.
Come on, Jane.
What did I do?
Hi, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'd love to be your partner for the science project. We could... Can you hold on for just one more second?
Mom!